Thank you. Thank you very much for this wonderful event and reimagining education. And the talk of the name is so beautiful. I was thinking about that name, and you mentioned about the danger of butterflies species. And butterfly is also very significant because it's a symbol of metamorphosis. We all are going through metamorphosis as a process of human evolution. And same time, the beauty and colors of life also. So I'm so thrilled by this name that you all organizers have kept it, Butterfly Talk. My native language is Hindi, so please bear with my English. Okay. And again, the beautiful title, Love in Action. Of course, love should be in action. Then the other thing, other feelings and other emotions, negative emotions will not dominate this world much more. So thank you very much, Ecoversity, Dan, and every I really saying namaste and lots of love and blessings from India to all of us beautiful souls here. Yeah, my topic is transformation of higher education pedagogy through spirituality, that is bhakti. First of all, I want to share some of my journey about love. Since childhood, I felt that love is the only power in the existence, and we born from love, and we will be merged into love finally. Of course, I was not able to articulate this feeling, this emotion, this deep emotion in words and ideas in my childhood. But in Hindi, we can say the anubhuti. That is the deep experience, deep feeling, deep emotion of love was always there. Then I got, of course, best education available in India, did my journalism course, master and PhD in Hindi literature, did some in various path of life. I did a lot of things. I always then I got, but I always felt kind of very alien to this world. I always felt alien in the family, education system, in the society. I always thought that I don't belong to this place. And through several years of experiences of different fields of life and exploring the different parts of spirituality, I realized that we all came here on the earth with the perfect programming. Divine has programmed us perfectly as a very beautiful, loving human being. But our upbringing, parenting, education, and socialization destroy our divine programming. And that divine programming, I can say that is pure love and injecting us feelings of fear, competition, comparison, distrust, jealousy, etc., etc. Of course, this is the need of we all know that this is the need of capitalist society. So the family, social and political institutions and education systems are structured to destroy our divine programming. That is pure love. And as an adult, we mostly operate life. Most of us mostly operate our life from fear and distrust, and that is the nature of ego. This understanding, or I would rather say this realization, I can say this in little enlightenment was eureka moment for me. And from there, as an educationist, I started a new journey with my students, with my colleagues. Journey of unlearning of fear and distrust and learning of love and trust. And in that, I always feel very, very lucky, very, very blessed to be born in India, because in India we have several traditions of spirituality, and in everyday life also we always there are always a reminder ki you have to work on yourself and you have see inside. Many things are there if someone is aware about their journey. So our country has a long heritage of bhakti literature and Sufi literature as well, which is full of wisdom, not only about inner transformation, but also about leading a beautiful worldly life. Okay, I'm doing very fastly. Gandhi got the values of importance of labor, cleanliness of body and mind, non-violence and truth from this bhakti movement. The balance of head, hand and heart is said to be essential for a spiritual practice in the bhakti movement. It is a wonderful thing that all the saints of the bhakti movement were artisan and they practiced labor throughout their lives. I have started our journey of universal love, compassion with my students through the literature and life stories of these saints. In this beautiful journey of reimagining of higher education, I kept four questions in my mind: learning to be, learning to learn, learning to work together, and learning to live together. UNESCO has also recommended keeping these four questions at the center of education. The process of the beautiful experiment involves silence, contemplation, and action. Each of our class begins with 2 minutes of silence. After that, we contemplate on some aspects of life, focusing on the course content, and then implement in the practical life. Only by going through these three processes, the circle of our learning completes, and the whole learning process pedagogy is based on love. As the great saint poet Kabir said in one of his couplet, I'm skipping that. Along with the college, we also converted a corner of our house into a university and named it Bhaktiversity. Workshop on the literature and lives of women saints were organized here. Women saints poems were translated, they were composed, plays were prepared on their lives. In all that process, what happened, I'm not discussing very much. As a result, many visible changes were seen in the lives of the students. A student disliked herself and felt there was nothing beautiful and creative about her. And within 6 months, she not only fell in love with herself and became more confident, but she also became the best actress of our theater team and played the lead role in many plays on women's saints. Almost all the students developed understanding of, okay.
This is time. I give you a 2 minute warning and a 1 minute warning. Would you say just a couple of sentences for you to please close?
Okay. So this is our journey. Not only this, they also learn many skills and inner understanding and life, all that.